Thank you very much to all of you to join us for webinar on opportunity for defense vendor to manufacture for Garden Reach Shipbuilders and Engineers Limited, a Government of India undertaking Ministry of Defense. The Indian government has taken the decision of making the country Atmanirbhar, self-reliant. Can I request you all to please mute? Yeah, thank you, sir. India, with its thrust on military modernization, is acquiring defense equipment and technology for years and for countries like Russia, US, France, and Israel. To reduce its external dependence from defense procurement, Government of India encouraged towards indigenization of the defense product. As part of Make in India initiatives of Ministry of Defense through indigenization, GRSC has made commendable progress by successfully incorporating a high percentage of indigenous content into the ships. Ample opportunities available for defense vendors to manufacture for GRSC. Regarding Abhyuday Mega Defense Cluster is setting up a greenfield mega defense project, which is in line with the vision of our Honorable Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi ji, under the schemes of Make in India and Atmanirbhar Bharat initiatives. Abhyuday already developed a virtual cluster for vendors registration to develop the product through cluster development approach. Now I request Sri Dhaval Rawal, sir, CMD Abhyuday Group and Chairman Defense Council KCCI for his welcome address. Dhaval, sir.
Yes, thank you, Nakul. Welcome to all. Good morning. I feel delighted to be a part of this webinar with GRSC, Government of Gujarat, and various industry associations. First of all, it is our great honor to have a veteran Air Marshal R.K. Dhir sir, advisor to Government of Gujarat Aerospace and Defense, Sri J. Ranjit Kumar, IAS, Commissioner MSME, Government of Gujarat, Commander Bhaskar Sen Gupta, GM, GRSC Limited. The gracious presence of these all dignitaries has made our this effort more promising and auspicious. I would like to welcome technical presenters of this webinar, Sri Harihar Das, DGM, GRSC, Mr. M. Chatroj, CDO, GRSC. They will provide us technical guidance and presentation on the various indigenization parts of GRSC. I also convey my heartfelt thanks to KCCI Kasia and Rajkot Engineering Association for being a part of this program. I also welcome all the participants and members of the various Chamber of Commerce and Industry Associations who are coming from the various SMEs, and they are willing to be a part of this product and vendor development program with GRSC. As we know, our country has a very great potential of being a defense hub of the world. Recently, Honorable Raksha Mantri ji has said that we are doing our best efforts to make India a global hub for defense manufacturing. Friends, this opportunity to SMEs is very huge, and if we can develop this defense industry, definitely we can provide a security to the nation, and also we can have a very sunrising sector for various business opportunities. I again convey my thanks to all the dignitaries who are present in this event, and I hope that this program will enable us to develop various SME vendors and engineering companies in this vendor development program. Thanks.
Thank you, Dhaval sir. I welcome everyone again. My name is Anant Dheer. I am Vice President Abhyuday for the defense projects in the southern region. We've got a very insightful welcome note from Dhaval sir, and I think all of us are committed to Mission Atmanirbhar. I next request veteran Air Marshal R.K. Dheer, PVSM, AVSM, VM, advisor to Government of Gujarat in aerospace and defense sectors, to deliver his special address.
Good morning, everyone. Nakul, can I share one document presentation? Last minute, I'll just.
I make you presentation.
Okay.
Yes, sir, please.
Okay. अच्छे वाली में ये इकट्ठी है सारी यही है यस ओके आई थिंक आई जस्ट पुट माय वीडियो बैक ऑलराइट कैन यू हियर मी
यस सर Please continue. Thank you.
Okay, I'll quickly run through the. Firstly, I would like to really thank MSME Commissioner Mr. Ranjit Kumar, who presently has not yet associated with the AND Gujarat Industries, and this is the first opportunity. And secondly, also GRSE Commander Bhaskar sir, welcome. To join Gujarat State and Abhyuday Group in an effort that Gujarat is coming on the map of defense manufacturers, and the kind of manufacturing activities which happen in Gujarat is well known. I don't have to say that we are leading in everything in the country. So, with that, I would like to quickly cover that what kind of facilities AND policy. Offers to the MSME partners who are present today, and this should encourage the BPSUs like yours and others to invest and come up for proposals for Make in India indigenization with the companies in Gujarat. So, if you look at the objectives and other attracting, we are trying to build the supply chain synergy with OEMs, for which we are getting all these. MSME companies in Rajkot sector and others, even in the country at various places, and Abhyuday is tying up with all of them so that they are available. Depending on their capability, they will be linked for a specific job. And focus areas are also enumerated in our this thing. Just for the various other people who are attending, there are various people in the MOD which are listed here who are into. Trying to encourage Make in India, and the new policies which have come up in the last 1.5 years, 2 years are really going to help private industry to come into various activities. So, if you were look at who all are the users, the defense forces, three of them, DRDO is coming up with new technologies, and sometimes those are passed on to MSMEs and other companies, like we saw in the times of COVID. ISRO also is one of the users. Then we have a Ministry of Civil Aviation, and under them there are various requirements for MRO which the industry can get in. Foreign OEMs and our small companies and our Indian DPSUs, and this is the ecosystem we are trying to build in Gujarat. Let's not worry about these major products. So. Gujarat, as you can see, is leading in so many activities. It is the highest FDI in the country is here, and there are a lot of logistic access benefits which are coming here. These are the number of companies you can see, and location wise you will see that from Rajkot you are so very well connected to all the ports, major ports in Gujarat, and subsequently all over the world. Big companies are already around. And you have Dholera, which is coming up in a very big way, and the connectivity to various places in the country is a real good advantage. So the Gujarat, in Gujarat, we have a very stable and centric government, where you can see that the policies are very well defined, and it's a policy-driven state. The industry has is fully, any OEM which has established in this state is fully satisfied. There are no labor issues. There is no shortage of electricity or water. In these areas, everything is being made available. The airport, the new AI airport is coming up. Another 1.5 years, it will be commissioned and ready in Rajkot. MSMEs, there are 35 lakh MSMEs units, and that's why the MSME commissioner will be able to throw some highlight on this. And Gujarat is a leader in sectors in where automobiles and other activities which they carry out. And these definitely, these companies can contribute and make important parts for our defense services. Various MROs can come up here, and in this sector, we can really progress very well. Now, these are not very important. Okay, I'll discontinue this sharing. You can remove that, please. Secondly, what I would like to highlight to our industry in Gujarat is that as far as Navy is concerned, the requirements of Navy have been taken on by our country since nearly last 25, 24 years. It was really visionary of the naval commanders that in way back in 2000 itself, they came up with various ideas. And in the defense acquisition procedures, if you see, there is a separate chapter for shipbuilding. And the shipbuilding yards, which have been there owned by the government in our various states and by the private enterprises, they have really delivered. And you can see in the last month, there was one aircraft carrier, indigenous aircraft carrier, which sailed out and just did first sea trial just to experience. And with using Russian technology in Vizag itself, I am personally privy to many of personal experiences where I have seen that we have really advanced and we have made very good submarines and nuclear submarines at that. So GRSC from the MOD's point of view is very, very relevant. And the kind of support it is providing to our Navy is applaudable. So from that angle, the GRSC has got a long list of indigenization items which they would like people in India to take on. And during the Aero India was the first time that Gujarat showed really its presence in A&D. And we had a stall, we had conducted a seminar. As a result, Abhyuday Group, which had signed an MOU with the Gujarat government, Karnataka government, also signed an MOU with GRSC. And we are really, really happy that you are today joining in a webinar along with the MSME industries and Abhyuday Group. And we want to assure you, I want to assure you also that MSME and all the industry today, definitely Industries Commissioner would have also joined, but because of the World Exposition and the preparations for a vibrant, they are really committed presentations with the CM. So we are here to assure you that in Gujarat, and we would like all the support will be given from the state to such MSME industries. We will hold their hand, and the A&D policy and the industry policy which came out last year are really encouraging, and these people also will get great benefits. With our output being highest, industrial output being highest in our state, I am confident that in few years' time, our MSMEs and other industry will really be taking on more and more percentage share of our indigenization and other defense manufacturing. With that, I would like to assure all the participants that we are here to support you. And with my experience, I will do everything and be able to explain the intricacies of defense manufacturing, the requirements, and also because of my understanding with the MOD and with the three services, we are definitely going to be in a good position to guide our industry so that they do not give any onus to the DPSUs and other services as far as quality and other delivery of the product as per specifications which is required. So that guidance will be there. With that, I would like to thank everyone here and let the session proceed. And definitely MSME Commissioner will have a lot of other points to cover, which will encourage both GRSE as well as Rajkot MSME Group to move forward and really give shape to this dream of our country and Atmanirbhar Bharat that our Honorable Prime Minister has been propagating and Make in India drive, which we have been taking on. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Your efforts from the government side have been beneficial for the industry, and I'm sure in the times to come, it will be advantageous for the MSMEs, not just in Gujarat, but other parts of the country as well. We are also joined by MSMEs from Karnataka region and other parts of India. So highlight from the current keynote from Dheer was, you know, the strategic location of Gujarat and the advantages, you know, advantages it brings for the industries and the MSME. So thank you again, sir. Moving on, I next invite Shri J. Ranjit Kumar ji, IAS Commissioner MSME, Government of Gujarat, to deliver his keynote address. Ranjit ji.
Very good morning. A veteran Air Marshal R.K. Dheer, advisor to Government of Gujarat, sir. CMD Abhyuday Group Dhaval Rawal ji, Rear Admiral V.K. Saxena ji, CMD GRSE Limited, Mohit Srivastav, and all the friends and business entrepreneurs. Today, I feel very happy to be the part of this webinar. You all know very well that Gujarat is the most entrepreneurial state in India. That is because of the entrepreneurs of Gujarat. Even during this, last year, during the lockdown also, the FDI, which India received, about 53% came to Gujarat. That is, that it establishes the entrepreneurial, the trust which we have. Then, as per the Niti Aayog's export preparedness index, we stand first, and there are so many indicators which establishes that Gujarat is the one of the best state to invest. For that, we all know that ecosystem is very, very important. For one vehicle, the engine itself is not sufficient. All the four wheels are to be intact and it should be operative. That this way, the whole ecosystem, that should be the main criteria for being the successful in the entrepreneurial endeavor. So in this case, if you see what is special, what is the great ecosystem Gujarat has. Gujarat is the home to Fortune 500 companies. About 3.5 million MSMEs are with us, 19 airports and airstrips with 3 international airports. We have 33,000 and odd hectares of industrial land available through special economic zones and regions. Labor peace and a large talent pool. We have 48 large ports handling 40% of India's cargo movement. 23% of Indian exports are done through Gujarat. We are the gateway to 150 countries. We are having the multicultural and welcoming community. If you see from the MSME viewpoint, the State Factories Act amended, and we have exempted the new companies for a period of 1,000 days from almost all labor laws. The best thing from our MSME is we have enacted MSME Act 2019. As per the Act, any industry, any entrepreneur, they can start their production without getting any required approvals or the certificates from the state government departments. Simply, they have to give their proposal, give their willingness to our single window system, that is IFP portal. Once they get themselves registered, immediately they will get the acknowledgement letter. That itself is enough for the entrepreneur to show to any department. For 3 years, no government of Gujarat department will come to your premises for any checking or inspection kind of thing. So to be more precise, up to 3.5 years, you will be free from getting those approvals. It doesn't mean that you need not to get, but while starting the industry, while starting the unit, you can apply. Even though it is delayed, up to 3.5 years, you'll be free to have those approvals. Then investor facilitation portal, we have been processing more than 6 lakhs applications in a year. Then online mega approvals, about 25 approvals are given through this single window system. Then we have the skilled manpower here. Shortly, we are going to have Indian Institute of Skills that will cater, that will empower at least 5,000 youths annually with modern training technologies. Then we are having very good, very big land bank that is fully digitized, GIS based map. So from any part of the world, anyone can see the current status of the land which is available. Then Index B, they are doing hand holding, they are facilitating, they are assisting all the companies and investors. There is one MRO facility, that maintenance, repair and overhaul facility, that is developed in the Ahmedabad airport. As per the water management, in the management, when the water management is concerned, as per the criteria of Niti Aayog, we stand at first. Then regarding the domestic and foreign companies, all are very, very much satisfied. They have expressed their satisfaction to us in various forums. Already we had one MOU with Bank of Baroda and SBI. As per these MOUs, if anyone applies for capital, for fund, for loan, if the loan amount is up to 5 crore, within 7 working days, they are expected to give the in principle approval to you. If the investment is, if the capital is more than 5 crores, within 21 days, you will be receiving the in principle approval. So both SBI and Bank of Baroda, they have executed MOU with us. This way, even getting capital also made easy. When we talk about other things like IPO offer and other things, then e-discounting system. For e-discounting system also, we have executed MOU with NSE, National Stock Exchange. Their office is in Ahmedabad. They are having their office. They are doing hand-holding from A to Z. So even you can have hedging. The hedging facility is also extended. Shortly, we are going to have a technology center, that is R&D kind of establishment that is going to be established in Rajkot. The investment would be 200 crores. It would be done through IGTR, that is Indo-German Tool Room. It is like hub and spoke model. The hub would be at Rajkot. Then there will be at least 10 extension centers. They are going to come. Already we have identified the land and the building in Sanand and Bhavnagar. Already we have given the space to IGTR to establish the extension centers. So this way, the overall, if you see the overall ecosystem, it is more conducive, because only the incentives, only the capital subsidy, interest subsidy, that is not sufficient to have the very good opportunity. That is not the only condition which would make you successful. So when you consider all these factors, a visionary leader, a visionary entrepreneur, surely they will be choosing Gujarat only. When we see about the aerospace and defense policy, in 2016 itself, government of Gujarat has come up with a very good scheme, very good policy. When we compare all the schemes of our industries department, all the schemes of government of Gujarat, this would be the most promising. It is giving more benefits. This is the first most scheme, the policy which gives more benefits to aerospace and defense sector. So I would request my colleague officer, Mr. Dharmesh, to give the PowerPoint presentation regarding this, so that you will get more details about what government of Gujarat is giving for this sector. I thank one and all for giving me this opportunity to present the views of government of Gujarat and the schemes of government of Gujarat. Thank you very much. Mr. Dharmesh, please. Yes, sir.
So thank you, sir, for giving me an opportunity. With the prestigious program of Government of India, that is the Make in India program, we have made a special efforts to attract investments and technology in aerospace. And for that purpose, we have identified some of the areas where incentives can be given. I'm sharing with you some of the key incentives here under that sector policy. And this sector policy is available till 31st December 2025. We are giving land incentives up to 50% of gentry rate in Gujarat. And if it is an intertidal land, we are giving 25% of that gentry rate. We are reimbursing nearly 100% of stamp duty and registration. No ceiling on that. With that, we have capital, that is a cash subsidy, which includes one-time capital subsidy up to 2.5 crore, that is 25 million rupees. And that is on the project cost or the eligible components, we are giving 25% on it. For interest subsidy, maybe it is MSME or large or mega projects, we are giving on domestic borrowings also, and on the external commercial borrowings also, we are giving up to 10 crores. That is the what we say main incentives we are giving under the aerospace and defense related policy. Attached to that, in additional to that, we are giving a net SGST for the period of 10%, and that is also on 100% reimbursement basis, and that is on 90% of eligible fixed capital. That is the maximum limit we are giving. On skill development for technical staff and for techno managerial staff, maybe it is national or international, we are giving 50% of actual training cost. With the R&D centers, we are giving 50% of the capital subsidy. If it is falling under defense sector, we are giving 50%. If it is under any private sector, in any other sectors or any other categories, we are giving 30% up to 5 crores for R&D establishment. These R&D centers would also be providing an access to our startups also, and that is the linkages we want, that startups to be connected to the R&D centers. Maybe it is a private companies or in aerospace or defense sectors, or maybe any other sectors. But as a special interventions, we are giving a little bit more under the aerospace and defense policy. For aerospace and defense related enterprises, we are giving rupees 1 per unit. That is the power tariff intervention is there for first 5 years. And electricity duty exemptions for first 5 years, 100% exemption is there. So apart from this, for any other benefits, there are a range of other benefits also to be given. They are sector specific also, which are under the IT and IT enabled services or electronics related things, garment, textiles, plastics, then capital subsidies also. We have some good interventions done in the industrial policy 2020 on as a post COVID revival. We have given that we'll be giving you in land lease on long-term basis. That is the substantial reduction in cost for doing business, and that is one of the lucrative one where we'll be provide long-term lease up to 50 years for any industrial enterprise at the rate of 6% of the market rate. That is to be provided for government land, and that GR is already there. We have for delinking ourselves from SGST. We were giving net SGST. We had delinked ourselves, and on any capital investments, no upper cap is there, and we are giving 12% on the fixed capital investment. And that is for setting up on any sector, for any category of industries, we are giving a fixed amount of incentives on their investment projects. If it is on relocation subsidies, we are giving on need-based and tailor incentives are given. Where any other countries, from any other countries, if any major project is coming up here, or when they want to diversify their supply chains, we are giving a case on case-to-case basis, and for that purpose, we are identifying the relationship manager also allocated to each of the cases. So with this, we have industrial infrastructure. That is one of the major things where we want that common industrial infrastructure should be developed. And for any viability gap funding under that industrial infrastructure, we are giving financial support up to 80%. Maximum up to 30 crores. If it is on the environmental infrastructure, we are giving 40% of that environment project cost up to 50 crores. And that is the way we want some interventions on common environment infrastructure facilities also. For specialized training programs, we have financial support up to 30 million for setting up the skill development centers also. So these are the major interventions, and I would also request that under these policies, we have identified some of the opportunities, and that these are the opportunities where investment projects can come up: artillery, automotive, shipbuildings, aircraft, ammunitions, small arms also, defense tech, electronic system, casting, MRO, and research development. So with this, we have made a special efforts to attract investments and technology in aerospace and defense, and thereby developing this emerging sector in the state with a sync to our industry policies also. So with this vision, we want to establish Gujarat as a hub for indigenous aerospace and defense manufacturing, developing global competition talent in this sector, and promote investments in R&D also to drive globally recognized innovation in product design also, manufacturing, and support establishing institutions in the aerospace and defense manufacturing ecosystem. So with this, I will be ending up and giving you our contact details in the next slide. Please. So you can contact our investor facilitation cell, which is in Industries Commissionerate, which we can you can have it as a toll free also. You can write email also. We have contact address of our Industries Commissioner and Managing Director of Index B also. So with this, thank you for giving me an opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. That was an insightful presentation. I'm sure the policies made by the government will be beneficial for the aerospace and defense sector. Thank you again. Next, I would invite Commander Bhaskar Sen Gupta, sir, GM QA VD and IEP of GREC Limited, for his special address. I also want to bring to notice for everyone that the presentation that we'll have with GREC and the technical specifications that they will share about their products in the next session are for all MSMEs across India. We are also joined by MSME groups from Karnataka, UP, and other states. With this, I invite Sen Gupta, sir, to deliver his special address. Thank you.
Thank you. Good morning. Thank you, Mr. Anand Dheer. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Shri Dhaval Rawal, CMD Abhyuday Group, and Chairman National Council of Defense Knowledge Chamber of Commerce of Industries. Shri Mohit Srivastav, CEO of Abhyuday Bharat Mega Defense Cluster, Mr. Ranjit Kumar from the MSME Commissioner, Air Marshal R.K. Dheer, PVSM, AVSM, BM, Advisor to the Government of Gujarat and Aerospace, ladies and gentlemen, and all dignitaries present. A very good morning to you all. At the outset, let me begin by putting on record my appreciation for the kind words of the Air Marshal on my company, that is GRSE. And I also take this opportunity to congratulate Team Gandhinagar and Gujarat for the for bagging the next Defexpo in March 2022, which will be held at Gandhinagar. A very hearty congratulations and a very good morning. It is indeed a matter of great pleasure and honor for being given this opportunity of addressing this August gathering here today. At the outset, I would like to put on record my appreciation for Knowledge Chamber of Commerce Industry and Abhyuday Bharat for organizing this webinar on opportunities for Abhyuday defense vendors to manufacture for GRSE Limited and facilitating interaction between GRSE and companies of this cluster aimed at indigenization of defense equipment manufacturing and import substitution through Atmanirbhar Bharat and Make in India initiatives. Self-reliance in defense has been the cornerstone of India's defense production policy. The recent call for Atmanirbhar Bharat has provided further impetus to realize the goal of self-reliance. Indian defense industry, primarily catering to the needs of the armed forces, has evolved with diversified product mix and market. Propelled by the recent successes in exports, India is set to realize its potential as an emerging defense manufacturing hub. And I cannot but again mention the great strides that the state of Gujarat has made, as has been brought out by the MSME Commission. When we look at the Indian defense sector and industry as such, it is giving us lots of hope and excitement on the prospects and growth opportunities in the coming decade. Recent policy initiatives and impetus being provided by the Government of India, Ministry of Defense, particularly on the Make in India, Atmanirbhar, Self-Reliance, Vocal for Local, gives us great confidence towards the future of this sector. The government has declared 101 products in the positive list of imports, which was earlier the negative list, but now we have given a better connotation, the positive list of imports, and we are still adding some more products. The third list, draft list is out, and more products will come onto the positive list for items which will has to be necessarily been procured from within the country. The defense acquisition procedure of 2020 has come up. No foreign procurement for projects above 200 crores. FDI limit from 74% to 100% through government approval has been approved. GST reduction in MRO of aircrafts. Insofar as the exports are concerned, the recent government has announced a target of $5 billion exports by 2024. Defense Export Promotion Policy has come up. Each DPSU has been assigned target countries for promoting defense goods, items, even for other private firms as well. Defense attaché have been given additional financial powers to promote our industries. And marketing representatives have also been appointed. Coming to the MSME sector, all these initiatives will immensely help our domestic interest industries and particularly the MSMEs. A number of policy initiatives to encourage and support MSMEs are showing a very positive intent of the Government of India to strengthen this very important sector. In fact, MSMEs have emerged as a backbone of the industrial economy, Indian economy, it provides employment of for over 11 crore individuals, contributing 6% of manufacturing GDP and 24% of service GDP of the country. These MSMEs play a very vital role in shipbuilding industry, as it is a labor-intensive industry. In fact, we had, we as GRSE have been consistently exceeding the targets that has been given for orders to be placed on GX. Coming to the shipyards. The shipyards primarily work as platform integrators, accommodating thousands of items of the mother industry. And we have a multiplying factor of 6.4, which is the highest in the industry. That means every one person in employed by the shipyard in the downstream industry, the employment multiplication factor is a factor of 6.4. That means if I employ 1,000 people downstream, it is 6,400 people who are getting employed because of my other ancillary requirements. Amongst the other defense industries, shipyards have played a vital role in helping Indian Navy to transform itself from a buyer's navy to a builder's navy over the last 60 years. If you look at our contribution to the maritime forces, we in GRSE have delivered 788 platforms, including 107 warships. This is a record of sorts for the country. GRSE is a profit-making and dividend-paying company for the last 27 years. In fact, those of you who have invested in our IPO, say about 2 years back, you would have seen your wealth double over the last 2-3 years. We are the first ship to deliver a warship in way back in 1961, INS Ajay. And incidentally, this INS Ajay is the first warship of the Bangladesh Navy. We have a strong order book of 25,000 crore rupees, and we have 5 projects of the Navy, Coast Guard, Government of Guyana, and 1 order from Bangladesh. We have a total of about 17 ships on order, and we are capable of building 20 ships concurrently. We have exported ships, say, to Barracuda, to Mauritius. We have got an export order to Guyana, and we have exported our ship to Seychelles, and we have got another export order for the Bangladesh. And recently, in some of our ships, we have achieved an indigenous content of over 90%. And if you look at our impetus on service, supporting the GRS to the MSMEs, about 30% of our procurement, which is over and above the cap of the requirement of 25%, our 30% of our procurement is from the MSME vendors. We have got about 750 registered MSMEs, and our total vendor strength is about 2,200. We also have 3 other business verticals: Bailey Bridges, Tech Machinery, and a diesel engine. And we have huge opportunities from MSMEs. Almost 80% of our project cost is on material and services, which we procure from outside. And this is what gives you the multiplying factor of 6.13, because so much of items we are procuring from the ecosystem outside. And out of which, 30% is from the MSMEs. Most of the, we have got about, the labor is about 3,500 we have got direct, and twice that we are employing indirect people in our ship. We have developed a strong ecosystem through strong and capable MSMEs, which is very vital for us to make warships at a competitive cost at a time. In fact, you will appreciate now all the warships that we are building are on competitive basis. We are no longer getting ships on nomination from the Navy or the Coast Guard, and we are competing very rigorously for these orders, for which we are looking at very competitive and high quality vendors for our input materials. And we are also looking for export orders, so we have a need to take inboard vendors of the highest possible quality and competitive price to be successful in our endeavor for export orders. Because if our industry is cost competitive with the required quality standards and on-time delivery, we have a huge prospect of winning orders for exports as well. I shall take this opportunity to invite you to join us in this journey. The Indian business world has to therefore begin a reorientation by focusing on the production of value-added goods through world-class facilities, adoption of advanced manufacturing technologies to gain competitiveness in cost, speed, innovation, and quality. In addition, appropriate investments also need to be made in skill and technological development, as well as R&D facilities to develop the local market. Indian manufacturers presently have the unique opportunity to blend the availability of advanced manufacturing technologies with low-cost labor to create extraordinary competitive advantage. I would once again like to thank Abhyudaya Bharat Mega Defense Cluster and Knowledge Chamber of Commerce and Industry for hosting such a wonderful and a powerful event. Thank you once again. Jai Hind.
Thank you so much, sir. Very motivating words, I would say, for the MSME sector of the country. And the insights that you've shared, and GRSE, as we all know, is one of the largest, biggest shipyards in the country, catering to the Indian Navy. And, you know, progressing them, helping Indian Navy to progress towards being Atmanirbhar. And I'm sure all of us truly believe that to be Atmanirbhar in the true sense, we have, all of us have to join hands from, you know, the MSME sector, the industry, the government. And we at Abhyuday are trying to achieve that. Thank you again, sir. I would also like to bring to everybody's notice that we are doing this webinar. We are joined by 42 participants from the Ahmedabad Engineering Manufacturing Association. So thank you for joining. I next invite Mr. Mohit Srivastav, CEO of Abhyuday Defense Group, to deliver his vote of thanks.
Shri Ranjit Kumarji from MSME, myself from Mr. Bhaskar Sven Guptaji from GRSE. I really appreciate their time and with the insight that they have shared today with us and to our vendors. And it's really empowering all our team to, you know, drive this engagement forward and see how we can create a best ecosystem and try to convert the self-reliance and Atmanirbhar Bharat prospects that we are looking forward to empower youth and MSMEs in India. I would just say that Abhyuday Bharat Mega Defense Cluster, on behalf of that, I personally welcome all of you. And also we'll say that we are fully committed for any engagement that is required to support the defense A&D sector in this drive. We have started this initiative in the very tough time, which is in the pandemic situation when we were facing this time. And we successfully found that, you know, that the vendors to whom we have approached has opened their arms and are looking forward for such opportunities in the defense sector. Our objective is that how we can engage more and more MSMEs into the defense sectors and create such programs where the insight from the companies like GRSE, PSUs, our government entities like MSMEs and our advisors who are the back who can back up all these MSMEs to understand and guide them and take the engagement in a very effective way and make our strong ecosystem in this area. Today we see that MSMEs are these vendors really play a very important role. What we are trying to do is, once we get this engagement with them, we are trying to understand their problem statements, the niche area that they want to get support from the government, from the private entities and public entities, and try to address them and bring in front of you so that we can get the right problem statements and try to solve it out and then support the drive. And so this is this. And today we are also engaging this vendor program with an objective that how we can profile those companies, map those companies, and allocate them with the right direction by giving them a handholding and our SME help desk support to give them a proper projects in hand. I would also say that the key notes that Akit Dheer Sirji have given us about Gujarat, he has already given a very strong efforts in building this ecosystem, and we are every time we approach him, he is always very enthusiastic, and he says that, you know, whatever is required to support yourself, your team, and your drive will be always there. I also had a very good insight from Ranjit Kumarji today, and I think MSMEs, since he is playing a very important role, I would also bring in front of him certain important points that are required to drive this program ahead. Apart from this, I also am very thankful and very glad for the GRSC and Mr. Bhaskar Sen Gupta ji for sharing his views and insight and allowing us to take this opportunity and pass this opportunity to our vendors and see how we can support them in this program. So apart from this is something very good happening today, that, you know, we have this program as a first vendor program that we are conducting. And today I would also request Shri Haridhar Das ji and Shri Chatur Raj ji to share the technical aspect of all the product list that we have in hand today, and give them an insight of how we can transform this product from import substituting the import and converting into the indigenization process. And we would also like to see forward such programs comes on a constant basis, and whatever best we can do as our commitment towards nation building, we will be definitely coming forward and appreciate to share any things that is required from our side. With this, I would just ask Anandji to invite Shri Haridas ji for sharing his technical views on the program. Thank you very much. Thank you, sir.
Sure. Thank you, Mohit sir. I just want to correct myself, which I mentioned earlier. We have 42 participants who are physically present at the Ahmedabad Engineering Manufacturing Association. So they are joined with us physically, not virtually. We will now be moving to the technical session. I once again thank everybody who joined us for the inaugural session. And for the technical address, I would invite Shri Haridhar Das from GRSC Limited to talk about the business opportunities and vendor development programs. Shri Haridas ji.
Or share. Niche. Presentation है ना BDD उसको start कर दे ना बोलो ना हाँ ये अरे उसको click करो यार presentation फिर open करो presentation आ गया शायद मेरे पास से हाँ प्रेजेंटेशन के पीछे है अरे हाँ हाँ इसमें जाओ
User is perfect. Please continue.
Respect, SARS. Dhawal Rawal, CMD Avadai Group. Air Marshal R.K. Dheer, Advisor to Government of Gujarat, Aerospace and Defense. Our HOD, Commander Bhaskar Sengupta, GM QA BT and IP, ERC. Sri Mohindra Srivastavji, CEO Avadai Group. A. Ranjit Kumar, IS, MSME Commission from Government of Gujarat. Last are members of the Avadai Group and my colleagues present here. It is a great pleasure for me to take part in this webinar on behalf of GRC Limited. I would like to share here that GRC and Avadai Group had MOU in Aero India 2021 in the month of February 2021 in Bangalore, with the goal set by our Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi to make India truly self-reliant, which is Atmanirbhar Bharat, short ANB. With this aim, Government of India has undertaken several policy initiatives like Make in India, Make to Indigenization, etc. Also, Ministry of Defense has developed a portal called Sridhan Defense, where manufacturer can see the items which all DPSU have published their requirement for those items being imported over the years, over the past. We noticed that with this platform, a lot of items, imported items, got indigenized over last two to three years with that help of this portal. As a shipbuilders, we know the strength of the manufacturers located in Gujarat region, and we are in firm belief that Avadai Group will play an important role in helping GRC's drive toward indigenization. This is the reason we are sharing this platform today. In coming to the technical session, I shall be giving brief about GRC indigenization success story and items yet to be indigenized. And the GRC's vendor development policy and vendor registration process, etc. In brief, the sequence of presentations will be many of this already our HOD is Commander Master Shanmugatha has covered, but I will be focusing more on the business opportunity and the vendor development and of course the indigenations. Next, yes. So this is actually our this in brief the summary of the brief history of the GRC. So it is already shared. This we founded in 1884. And the Government of India has taken over in 1960. And already this, you know that this INS Ajay was the built by GRC. It is the first warship, indigenous warship. So we are also exported this warship this in 2015. That is CGS Barracuda to Mauritius. And this year also we have exported one warship to Seychelles. Yes. Regarding company profile, this will be sharing on this video. So that will give the this clear idea of the GRC. Coming.
Bhaskar sir, actually the audio is not clear for that video. If it is possible for you to elaborate something about that video.
Okay. So that means
yeah, we'll do that.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
So this AR actually will be okay. So basically we have sir in our company we have that two division basically. We have one is shipbuilding division, another is engineering division. And ship division we have three units. That is the main unit, FOJ units, and another is RBD Rajabagan Dockyard units. These three consist of the ship division. We have engineering divisions. There also we have three units. That is one belly bridge units, another deck machinery units, and another is DP Ranchi engineering units, engine manufacturing units. And we have also this training center for this marine engineering and all technical training center related to shipping. This is the our this infrastructure that has been already given in that our video. So this is the main unit infrastructure in brief. Next, and this is the fit out jetty FOJ units. Here actually after this ship is launched, all this fitting out activities, painting, etc., all are, and the ship is made ready for delivery. And this is the Rajabagan Dockyard. Here this complete activity of small ship we do. And altogether we have it's around this capacity consisting of these three units. We have around 20 to 24 ships we can build concurrently. In post year, in last shift, we can make 8 to 9, like 9, 10, like more or less 8 to 10 we can make, and small also 12 to around 12 we can make. Like in around 20 to 24 ships we can construct on built concurrently, and pre-launch stage it is around 10, or post-launch it will be around 10 to 12. So now coming to this product profiles and the video only portrait, this all the categories of ships like frigates, corvettes, and this LST survey vessel, all types of this defense requirement we can make except this submarine. In addition to the, we also are capable of making like this hovercraft, this or commercial ship or any special purpose ship requests. That also we are capable and built in fast. Presently we are India's mostly on this defense ship and warship. Next. So the so far we have built 107. We have delivered 107 warship. Out of that, 70 are for our Indian Navy, and half of the 35 is for our Indian Coast Guard, and two ship we exported, and the others we have 359. This is various types of this commercial ship, and like boats, etc. 88. So this is the belly bridge. In belly bridge division, we are the pioneer in making the belly bridge in India. And so far, actually, we have delivered more than more than 5,100 ship. Sorry, we deliver. Our market share is more than 60%, and we are the exporter of belibis to our neighboring countries like Nepal, Bhutan, and Sri Lanka, and all state governments. But most of the state governments are those who are in the border area or in hilly area. Those state governments are our customers, because this is the way to establish the faster connectivity. So like the border security force, army, and defense purpose, this belly bridge is very much useful. Then we have this under engineering division, that is the deck machinery. So in deck machinery, this is the shipyard which has the deck machinery divisions. And this deck machinery division, we generally our main products are our this deck crane, capstan, hydraulic davits. Then also we make marine pumps. Then rail-less hollow traversing systems. And this is the Indian plant located in Dhaka, Ranchi. And they are and we are this so we are into MU with MTU, tied up with MTU, and we build this on marine engines, and we use those engines for our equipment as well as we also supply to other shipyards. Now coming to business opportunity, our GMs have already told this around 70 to 80% is the material used in constructing the ship, and around 30-35% it is a labor portion. Although this ship in building is a labor intensive job, but with the change of little this working method, like this introduction of modular constructions, that has improved the productivity, but still it is a labor intensive job. The ongoing project, we have at the moment six contract which we are under execution. Of the six contract, total number of ship is 27, and four is already being delivered, and remaining ship we have to deliver within 2016 we have to deliver this all these ships. And out of that, you know, fifth and sixth number, that means two a contract we have this export contract. One is going up for some green ferry. This is not a warship, but it's a ferry, and another is Bangladesh Petroport Surveillance. That is for Bangladesh Fishery Department. Recently, we have built those contract, and these contracts are under execution, and we will be delivering those for ships as per the delivery schedules. This our vendor base. We have a strong vendor base. More than 2,000 vendors registered with us. Is from from West Bengal as well as across India. And MSME we have 830 MSME vendors, and SCST and women is very less, 5 each. And out of that, we have also this out of this 2,157 vendors, we have around 150 is service vendor, and around 80 to 90 we have the subcontractor who are actively engaged. They watch in our shipbuilding activities. So that is the combination that we use. In addition to that, we are looking for this vendor for our this import substitution or indigenization purpose. As a business opportunity, there is a two verticals. One is service, that means subcontracting part. Another is this our supply, that is the raw materials, equipment, and other supplies. So these are the activities in shipbuilding activity, which is that's listed. This fabrication, erections, and plumbing, electricals, plastic painting, then some small fabrication, material handling, and other host of activities that we have segregated. This is a small one, but there is a lot. So we will not be explaining much about here. This is the manufacturer supply parts. These are the some generic materials. It is not a high-tech materials. For MSMEs and this, we are sourcing these materials like electrical items, marine pumps, castings, ferrous, non-ferrous, light fabrication, labor, patternized valve, pipe fittings. Pipe would be in the MS and then this people is very much used in large quantity for shipping. Then cables. So we have a supplier in Gujarat, located in Gujarat, Dabar Industries. They are the one of the major suppliers for our this patternized air cable. Then we have firefighting items. Then other like this air conditioning, water filtration, and those sort of this equipments, then like your laundry equipments. Those are actually we are sourcing from the MSB vendors. So most of the items we need, that also is available in our website. So now I am focusing on the this indigenization portion. So as I mentioned earlier, the Srijan portal, Srijan defense portal, that is administered by government of MOD. So where we can upload our the curriculum and the item which we are at the moment importing. So those items we are uploading in the website, the Srijan portal. So at the moment, KLSC has uploaded 55 items. Out of 55, already indigenized 24. That is, we say the success story of GRSC was the indigenization drive. And all these items, 12 number of farms has shown interest in indigenations. And it is in matrix we are explaining this. We are noting interest shown items and interest not shown yet items. Interest shown items out of 55, 12 items interest shown. And out of this 12, 3 we indigenized. And 9 items still remains. This out of this 9 items, 4 items are no longer because those items when interest from this is already outsourced because those requirements with project based on our project requirements. Our requirements are not standard. It is a project specific because within a time if we do not find any response or not suitable this vendor after evaluation we find that the vendor will not be suitable to make this item, then definitely we have to go for foreign source. Then so not interest from items 43. So out of that, those 21 we have indigenized through our not through Srijan portal but through our off the line Srijan portal. So that is 21 we indigenized and 3 are on order stage. So once these 3 also we received and we installed, then it will become 24. 21 plus 3, 24. And out of 43, 21 items out of remains means to be indigenized, and one item is not required because this is also already, is already procured. So that is more or less the actually our indigenization status, and remaining is there 30 items that is available in defense portal, and we have found recently some more items we have to upload it. So we will be uploading. So the Abu Dhabi group cluster members may visit a defense portal and find which of the items they are interested. So they can express their interest there. So we will be establishing the we contact them. And of course, this our we are in touch with this Abu Dhabi group. To them also, they can come, and we will help them to how to proceed for the next step. So these are the list. This Srijan defense portal items which are not yet indigenized. But there are some item is interest from some vendors. For some items, still not interest from stage it is there. So I request this interested vendors, industry may look into that and they can respond or they can directly offer contact to us. So it like that, it is there around 25 items. Next slide in totality. So these are available in different Srijan portals. I request everybody to visit there. This now vendor development. Actually, we are looking for a vendor to supply raw materials and equipment and offer service. The initiative in the vendor development, some of the things like this existing vendor list are displayed in our GRSC website. So you can have some idea which are the vendors we have already. Then for their, we have established, we have introduced this vendor rating systems. For vendor rating, this we actually, this encourage and appreciate them in case of partner rating is not good, we all of course this suggest some correcting measures so that their rating is also improved. Then we have also the vendor grievance system. Say suppose any issues are there that which are not being resolved or there is some improvement, so they can express their grievance. We also give the preference the vendor those who are already registered in MSME MSA or Udayam, JM and E-Trades. So they will give the preference for our registration. General criteria, actually we look for this technical capability infrastructure and their office record, manpower positions, and they are the business which actually item they are looking for in the, their competency, and of course the financial spend. So our, as per the this government media guidelines, we are exceeding this purchase means the MSP purchase by around we are achieving 30%. Other facilities like this purchase preference 4% purchase preference to SGST and plus all this MSP related benefits which government means MSP ministry or has published, we are abiding by and passing on all these benefits to the MSP vendors. And this is regarding the registration process. We have this online system as well as this manual systems. Online systems, it is in our website, it is published, the GRC website, grc.co.in, grc.in. And there you find this online vendor as well as manual one. For online system, you will submit. You fill up this required information and take the printout and forward the document to us. And another one is this manually also you can download the form and fill up, and the required document you forward to our vendor development department. And based on there, this year we will evaluate and then we'll intimate for the registration and further actions. So we have the list of people to whom you can reach. Those are available in your website. Request the interested vendors to go through our website and express their interest for registration. So these are the few contact persons. These are all available in our website. So we are committed to self-reliance in maritime security. So this is our main motto. And let us make in India. So that should be our objective. And with that, I am ending my this presentation here. Joining next, my colleague M. Chattaraj. He is a design engineer. He will be giving this some actual this what are the items from this design side they are looking for. So those details will be shared.
Yeah, thank you very much, Haridas sir. Now we will take one-to-one question after the second presentation of Mr. Chattaraj. Okay. I request Mr. M. Chattaraj to please start with the second presentation. Then after that, we will start our one-to-one questions. Yeah. Thank you.
Sir, very good afternoon to all the dignitaries and our senior colleagues present here today. In the past few presentation, we have covered mostly about our history and the product range and the vendor development aspects. I will now take you quickly through this small presentation about the indigenization happenings and the opportunities for MSMEs through indigenization with this short presentation. Go to the next slide. We'll try to cover these four areas: indigenization of the ship systems, an overview, and then we'll try to cover indigenization efforts so far given by GRSE, and then we'll go to the major and minor future requirements, and we'll also cover approach one. Next. This is in short, basically, we have categorized our product, our equipments in three categories: float, move, and fight. Float is basically the hull, move is the engineering part, and fight is the weapons. As you can see from the percentage in move and fight category, there are ample opportunity for indigenization, because this percentage is not only about GRSC. This is a pan India scenario now. So I believe there is ample opportunity for the industries to pitch in into this sector. Now our products are categorized in three segments. One is class A, class B, and class C. As you can see, this class A and class B are basically our customer nominated vendors. So we do not have much of a choice but to go to the nominated vendors for class A and class B items. And for class C, it is entirely up to the shipyard to decide. Yes. I will just take you through some major indigenization effort that has been put in by GRSC in the recent past. Next. As you can see, this is the typical example of our indigenization effort. This is a helicopter connecting gear for railways helo traversing system. This we have developed through one of our business verticals, one of our units in Taratala Deck Machinery. They have developed this equipment, and this is very useful for the naval platform so far. Next. Now this is another product from our one of our major business verticals for portable bridges. These portable truss bridges are usually meant for automobile traffic and not for the pedestrians. So this is one product we have recently developed. Next. And this is, as you can see, it's a two-way modular truss bridge. This also our Bailey Bridge engineering vertical has given their efforts, and in the past couple of years we have developed these two products. Yes. This is a typical thing for the naval platform. We are presently engaged in indigenously developing this thing. This is a telescopic halo hangar, which will provide proper space utilization in naval platforms. So we'll have a telescopic hangar where we can house the halo, and when the halo is on the air, we can utilize that space by means of this telescopic halo hangar. We are presently engaged in developing this thing for one of our ongoing projects, and this is also through our own business vertical. For Deck Machinery, they are primarily engaged in developing this thing indigenously. Next. So we have talked about our diesel engine unit in Ranchi. As you can see, we are having an MOU with MTU Germany to develop engines here for our ongoing project P-17 Alpha Frigate. We are developing this 1 megawatt DA in collaboration with MTU. So this is basically a kind of TOT, and we are importing the sub-assemblies, and we are basically integrating it there, and we are carrying out all the tests and trials and everything there. So maybe it's not a raw material stage so far, but still we are putting our effort to build on this. Now coming to those were some major areas. Now some of the small things we are continuously working on. This is one of such example. This is a bilge plate. This is a kind of plate that all the naval platforms, all the naval ships are using to cover the bilge area. Now this is a typical arrangement that we have developed indigenously, and we have also applied for a patent for this item. That is why this becomes so important for us. Maybe it's a very trivial item, but it's very useful for all the naval platforms, and we are pitching on this. Second. Now these are some small initiatives which is going on in our in-house facilities, like bending of plates and all. Some customized bending is happening. So rather than sourcing, we are developing it indigenously. Next. Now, if you see in the last couple of years from 2018 to 2021, targeted 74, out of which 38 has already been granted. So we are giving continuous effort towards indigenization and developing the new products. Next. Now I'll just take you through some major areas in where MSME industries can pitch in for our future requirements. Now as you can see, all the naval platforms, all the naval ships, we generally have customized firefighting system for our ordnance magazines, where you can see there are various types. One is manual, one is automatic, one is bulkhead cooling, then RRSS and inhibitor system. I'll just try to give some briefs about each of these systems. This is one area where we are focusing to develop more and more indigenous content. In our present ongoing projects, we have already developed some of the vendors, and they are also indigenously supplying some of this magazine firefighting system. Earlier we used to import it from Russia, so that barrier we could break. So now we are going ahead with indigenous vendors. Next. This is a rapid spray kind of a system. It's basically pneumatic. It is having a detection system integrated to it, and it works on the seawater sprinkling platform. So basically it's a rapid reaction spray system for our magazines, where we employ this type of pneumatic automatic seawater based sprinkling system. Next. Now this is another type of typical type of inhibitor, magazine inhibitor system, where we have a highly propellant ordnance. There we used to employ these type of systems as per the naval guidelines and all. So this is one area which we can think of developing indigenously. Next. Now, apart from firefighting system, this propulsion and shafting, which remains as the most critical part of the ship for any shipbuilder. But as you can see, we have so far, we have hardly done anything indigenously. Most of the things, I mean, propeller, shafts are imported so far. Recently, some of the indigenous vendors are trying to develop something like Gita Engineering and all. They are working on the steering gear systems. But for main propulsion, shafting, propeller, CPP, brackets, we are still dependent on major imports. Basically, for any industry to venture into this area, they will have to have a major manufacturing facility, and they need to collaborate with classification societies and Indian Navy as well. So this is one area we are looking to increase the indigenous content in the coming years. This is a typical example. Why? Because this has come up very recently with our state government. We are doing a collaboration for this electrical propulsion arrangement. Government, as per the government guideline, we are trying to shift to the non-conventional energy sources, where we'll have a propulsion, battery driven propulsion, and it will have battery charging panels also inbuilt to this platform. So this is a new venture. We are working on it, and we are looking forward to make it totally indigenous to total indigenous manufacturers. Next. This is deck cranes. Mr. Hari Atas has already told about this deck cranes. This is a product of our tech machinery business vertical. They are working on this. This we could, in all future requirements, this is a typical item which all the Navy ships, all the naval platform, even civil platform also, this deck crane is a very essential part. So we can look for a, order for coming projects for this particular item. I will go to the minor scope. I'll just try to touch one or two items. Like this is one thing, it's a mechanical kind of remote operation for various types of valves, which often we require for our different projects. This we are sourcing it from some of the Indian vendors presently. As you can see, it's not a very complicated engineering, but still it's a good solution. Next. Now this is one area we are still exploring. This window wiper, this remains a critical part of the ship, especially in high seas and rough weathers. And this quality and IP protection for the outdoor units is very critical. So, and reliability as well from the point of view of navigation of the ship. So this is so far we have been importing. Now we are looking forward to indigenously develop this through Indian vendors. These are fire detection sensors. These, some of the Indian vendors are now supplying this. It could be optical smoke detector, heat detector type of a thing. Next. And lastly, this non-watertight doors. This we are trying to develop indigenously, but then we are facing some challenges to make it a fire resistance rating. So far, we have not succeeded, but we are working on it, and hopefully we'll find some solution in future also, if you can pitch in. Next. And the approach path, basically, as I told, we are dealing in three categories. Category A, B, and C. Category A and B were our client, Navy used to nominate the vendors. So, MSME or other industries can always pitch in, but they need to have a concurrence from our naval headquarters to participate in this type of equipments. And for category C, OEMs can directly approach the shipyard. I believe Haryanda sir has already told you about the portal and how you can connect with us, and we'll look forward to your our future engagement for all our future projects. Thanks. That will be all from my side. Thank you very much. Thanks for this opportunity. Thank you. Jai Hind.
So much, sir. Jai Hind to you as well. And I think your presentation has helped and will continue to help the very useful for the And with this, we will move to the question and answer round. Nakul.
Anand bhai, thank you. Thank you very much, sir. I provide all the access to the participants. Is there any question? Please ask. Please unmute and ask and tell about yourself. Mr. Moin, you want to ask something?
Yeah, thanks for the opportunity. Can you hear me?
Yeah, we hear you.
Okay. So my question would be just a context wherein I am from a company called Digital Shark, wherein we are an MSME based out in Karnataka. So my question is, we are an independent design house wherein we deal in embedded and IoT related software requirements, as well as we have expertise in designing HMI solutions or human machine interface solutions. And we are a design house, not a manufacturer. So we would like to understand from GRE team, what kind of opportunities can embedded design house such as us expect from this kind of platform, wherein we have already supplied a lot of HMI solutions to US-based clients and also Singapore-based clients. We have very much experience in this field. So that's my question.
Your name, please, once again?
Syed Moin.
Syed. Acha, Mr. Syed, let me congratulate you. I think you are in a very exciting space. If you have recalled my opening address, we as shipbuilders, we are integrators of a share of the vessel. What we do is your kind of solutions like HMIs are there in the ships. What we do is we buy systems from various companies, like we buy something called an IPMS, Integrated Platform Management System, for which manages the ship's platform and the data network, which is installed in the ship. Now, what we do is we buy these systems are designed and installed by another company, say Larsen & Toubro or L3 India. L3 is, by the way, in Bangalore. So they design the entire IPMS system or BDCA, Battle Damage Control System, for the ship, and they install it. They procure the HMIs and put it in our platform. So actually, we do not go directly to people like you who design HMIs. We buy from another mini integrator. So you would be well advised to talk to companies like Larsen & Toubro, talk to companies like L3 Maps, talk to say Bell. Bell also gives us some HMIs, which will ultimately find their way into the ship.
Sure, sir. We'll look forward to this opportunity and the information you've shared. Thanks for the inputs.
Welcome.
Any other question? Mr. Prashant Ram, you want to say something?
Good morning, and thank you very much. It was indeed a nice presentation and good effort by Abhyuday and GRSE. I am based out of Bangalore, and we have a MSME industry which is recognized by DGQA, and we are supplying a lot of items for Indian Navy through Bharat Electronics and directly. My only question is that we have a list of 37 items which GRSE is looking for indigenization. How to get the more detail about these items if you are interested?
You can write to us and indicate to us which are the particular items that you would like to develop. We will then connect you with our design specific design team, and who can share the technical details many a times what happens is, as I think, as Mr. Chattoraj had mentioned earlier, you see, the shipbuilding material is divided into three categories: category A, category B, and category C. Category A and B are nominated by our customer, that is the Indian Navy and the Coast Guard. They nominate these items. So we have to go to those specified vendors with a specified specifications handed down to us by our customer. The category C items are broadly general use items which are indigenized, for which we do not import. They're almost 100% indigenized. The category A and B is actually, they are under the hard control of a customer. So what we can do is, we can interface you with our customers, that is the Indian Navy. We can tell you where exactly to go, and then you will have to take up with the Navy, get your item type approved or by the Navy. And once that is done, then you will automatically, you will find yourself into the naval ecosystem.
Thank you very much, sir. It's very clear.
Yeah, is there any questions? Mr. Puneet, you want to ask something?
Yeah, good afternoon.
There was a question, I think, Shashidhar Palaki. Generally requires lots of testing, whether GRSC offering or offloading testing services. We have some very rudimentary testing services. We do have some NDT, this thing, which we do. Otherwise, for equipment per se, the testing is normally, it will be a plethora of testing. It will not be just NDT. There will be other testing also if you are developing equipment. So that will have to be done either at NSTL or at some proper NABL accredited lab, which are having more diverse testing equipment. Yes, we do some NDT, but that is for our shipbuilding day-to-day work.
Sir, whether are you offloading NDT services, sir?
Yes, we are, like radiography, we are offloading, then the radiography. And sometimes NDT like your ultrasonic testing also we offload for our, that is for the structural work, we do that.
Sir, we are from Karnataka. We are one of the NDT service provider and the NABL and NADCAP accredited laboratory. So do we, entertain any outside Gujarat or outsiders of Karnataka to, cater such kind of services, sir?
These are open tenders. You can participate in these tenders. All this NDT testing is in the open domain. Whenever we tender out, it is in the open domain, you can name. Hitherto, the service has to be provided in Calcutta, means in GRSE at the site. So often what will happen, and it is a continuous requirement, that today I may require 15 NDT shots. Another 2 days, I will be requiring another 10 NDT shots. It is in that manner. So if you are and this is published in the open tender, so you are most welcome to participate in our tender and join us and provide service.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
I request to please unmute yourself and ask a question with your complete details. Thank you. Is there any question?
Sir, good afternoon. This is Puneet Chaudhary. I am director of Inverbras Electricals from Bangalore. We are an MSME and we are registered with DQAN. I want to ask, sir, that this our name is already there in the DQAN compendium, but we are not getting any RSQs or the tenders from GRSE. Do we need to register separately for GRSE, sir?
See, it's better you register. But what is the product that you
Sir, we are into power electronics and we are supplying to Indian Navy the automatic changeover systems, junction boxes, power panels, power supplies.
These are all open tenders. So if you have a look at our site, what will happen is you will see that these JBs, power panels and all are open tenders. So you can participate whether you're registered or you're not registered. Okay. But registration helps because whenever this kind of tender comes out, and automatically you will get an alert that so-and-so tender has come. So you will be able to participate. But nevertheless, even if you are not registered, if you are keeping an eye open on the our website, mm-hmm. you will see that this open tender has come out. So, but I would still advise you to register yourself with GRSE, so that you get that, at least you will get that alert.
Thank you, thank you. And I would just like to thank the complete team of Abhidya and Dhaval Rawal sir and Nakul and Anandir sir. It was really nice interacting and having all the information from GRSE. Thank you so much, sir.
Yeah, thank you very much, Puniji. Is there any other question? Mr. Hitesh, you want to ask something? Please unmute yourself and tell me about yourself. Hitesh ji, or any other question? Yes, sir. One question is from Hitesh Jadhav. He is from Monocraft Private Limited. They are having a huge facility for precision machining and forging facilities at Rajkot. And he went through the list, but he confused how can he directly or indirectly cater GRSC services?
We are looking for slightly larger integrators. Say we buy pumps, we buy bulbs, as an example. So finished products. So now if he has got a machining and they basically he has to move up the value chain and come out with products like the previous gentleman, he's making power panels. He's come out with a product like a power panel. So I think if he moves up the value chain and starts creating products, I think that way he will find
that he can collaborate with our suppliers of the finished products what we acquire from other OEMs. They can always participate, collaborate with our suppliers. That way they can find a opportunity to develop their business.
Yeah, Hitesh, I hope you got your answer. Is there any other question?
Can you hear me, sir?
Yeah, we hear you. Please, sir.
Yeah, sir, I'm Rajan from LT Cables and Instruments. We are an MSME registered. And basically, we manufacture wires which are not conventional wires. They are PTFE and silicon rubber insulated for high temperature applications. So I have two sets of questions for you. So the first question is that whether we do have any opportunity for the same, for those type of wires that can resist the higher temperature, and as well as we also manufacture the temperature sensors. Apart from that, sir, this is the first question what I like to put it on to you. Another one is that for these wires, basically HAL and all, they have a huge requirement, especially for in aerospace engineering and all. But they have a certain restrictions to us. They wanted certain registrations, pre-registration for that. Say LCS or registration or something like that. So do you have that process, to get our wires registered somewhere else and then to become your vendor for the same?
You have got two products. You have got cables. I presume you are talking about power cables.
Sir, they are not only the power cables. They are also used for temperature sensors. Temperature sensors can be also manufactured.
There are two products you talked about. You have talked about temperature sensors and you have talked about power cables. Absolutely. Are you manufacturing both?
Yeah, we are manufacturing both, sir.
Both. Insofar as power cables are concerned, so Navy has prescribed EBXL cables, and I would recommend that you get yourself registered with the DQA Navy. I think DQA Navy is there, maybe there in Baroda, is there, or in Mumbai. You can get your product validated by the Navy and get included in the compendium of cable manufacturers of the Navy. Once you have done that, then you are automatically your candidate for supply of cables to not only GRAC, to all the defense shipyards, and to material organizations of the Navy, you will be able to supply power cables. Insofar, this is regarding the cables. Insofar as your temperature sensors are concerned, what happens is this temperature sensors constitute part of some equipment. I mean, we do not buy temperature sensors loose. They come as part of the various equipment. So you will have to, that also it would be prudent to get the sensors approved by Navy. Then the equipment manufacturers, various for say shafting, for say gearbox, or anything which is say heat pumps and all that, ventilation system, you could get in touch with those this thing. Like in Gujarat, there is a company called Shree Refrigerators. So they will buy a lot of temperature sensors. So you could go to Shree Refrigerators or Johnson Control and supply them with the temperature sensors for their equipment. Mostly it will be in HVAC and the main machinery, in engines, diesel alternators. These equipment will have various temperature sensors. So you will be supplying to those manufacturers. That is how it will come to us through another major equipment.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you for the feedback.
Yeah, thank you for question. Is there any other question? Ms. Deepa from Ultra Care, you want to say something? Ms. Deepa? Ms. Deepa from UltraClap have a question. Please clarify.
I answered her question in the previous this thing. I think she would have this thing got the answer.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Now this is a supplementary question. How to become our approved vendor? That is very simple. Go to our website. There is a menu-driven thing in the vendor portal where you click on the Make in India. You can see the form. You download, I mean, take a printout of the form, fill it up, put all the, and the form tells you what all you have to be given. You know, documents are required to be given. So just collate all those documents, send it across to us. We do have a process of you know, registration, this thing, and we will get it done. The only thing is, insofar as cables are concerned, it would be prudent that you first get yourself registered into the Indian Naval ecosystem. If once you are qualified by the Navy to supply cables to the Navy, then it is very simple. Then you can get registered in the DPSUs very, very easily. Cables, we will, if you're a cable manufacturer, we will just do the, see the KYC of your, you know, financials and other commercial this thing. And technically, we'll just straight away accept once Navy has approved.
Yeah, thank you, sir. We are just mentioning that Abhyudaya Bharat will guide you all with the registration process under vendor registration program in support with GRSC. Is there any other questions? Please just unmute yourself and ask the question. I think no other questions from the participants.
Nakul sir, one more question. Just Bhaskar has mentioned that for this cable registration, we need to first go to Indian Naval ecosystems. So can you guide us how do we approach them for our registrations of our wires and cables, sir? I mean, do you have a process for the same or whom to approach?
It is done by the DGQA organization. In fact, if you do a Google search of Director General Quality Assurance, they have got in the Navy, they have got two, DGQA Warship Products and DGQA Naval. The DGQA Naval, he is the one who approves the cables. And if I'm not mistaken, there is a DGQA Navy inspection agency in Baroda. And you'll have to approach them. They will come visit your premises, they will see the product, they will look at your quality standards, your quality manual, and then they will decide to board you or onboard you for the naval battle scale. They're normally EBXL cables. So you will have to have a facility for manufacturing EBXL cables and approach the DGQA. They have a well-established system for qualifying material for the Indian Navy.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Is there any other question? I think no questions. किसी को भी कोई क्वेश्चन है तो प्लीज राइट अ मेल टू अस द माय ईमेल आईडी इज मेंशन ओवर देयर आई आल्सो मेंशन इन द चैट आल्सो सो यू कैन क्वेश्चन अस वी विल गेट बैक टू यू आफ्टर दिस प्रोग्राम एज वेल एंड नाउ आई रिक्वेस्ट श्री धवल रावल सर सीएमडी अभ्युदय ग्रुप टू फॉर हिज कंक्लूडिंग रिमार्क्स एंड वोट ऑफ थैंक्स धवल सर
थैंक यू नकुल फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई कन्वे माय sincere thanks and regards to team GRSE, Sri Commander Bhaskar Sen Gupta sir, Sri Hariharan sir. Hello, am I audible?
My pleasure.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Mr. Mahendra Chatroth sir, for giving this time to all these vendors and explaining in very detail the procedures and opportunities to register with the GRSE. I also convey my thanks to Air Marshal R.K. Dhir sir and our MSME Commissioner Sri Ranjit Kumar sir. I also convey my thanks to Kasia and Rajkot Engineering Association and Knowledge Chamber for giving this opportunity to interact with GRSE. Under this vendor development program in Abhyuday Bharat Mega Defense Cluster, we will continue to provide our handholding to various SMEs, and we will also run one program to register all these vendors. Due to this corona pandemic, we could not meet personally, and it was not possible for us to convey any meetings for this kind of event. So we are meeting in this online webinar, and we are requesting all the participants and SMEs to write to us on mail wherever they require any kind of support. Definitely our team will approach you, and we will work as a bridge in between the GRSE and the SME engineering companies. So thanks all for giving your time and being present in this event, and I hope that this is just a beginning, and we will definitely be successful to provide some indigenized parts and systems to the GRSE under this Make in India and Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan in defense sector. Thanks.
Yeah, thank you very much, Dhaval sir, and thank you very much, Bhaskar Sen Gupta sir, for being with us today, and Sri Harihar Das Saab, Sri M. Chattora Saab, and all other dignitaries with us, and all the participants, thank you very much. We will be in touch after this webinar as well. So thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.